All of my 3D fashion creators and designers, today's video is specifically for you. If you're working in 3D and you need a way to organize all of your 3D assets in one place, regardless of which 3D tool you're using, and share those assets with your clients, allow me to introduce you to Folio 3D. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Mikkel Drew Pelham. I am a digital fashion specialist teaching digital fashion design and communication through my company, 383 Design Studio, as well as various other universities, including the Fashion Institute of Technology. I talk about digital fashion software, design communication, and fashion entrepreneurship on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. Most of you already know 3D can help your client really see the creative vision more clearly and help you make design decisions more quickly. But for 3D to really work, your clients need to interact with your assets the way that you do, rotate, zoom in, and truly see what you mean when you describe a fabric as lightly textured. Now, some of you are probably using those free-ish platforms from your 3D software company. The problem is that each platform only works with their own software. And most 3D designers I know work with multiple programs, whether that's Style 3D, Clo3D, Browseware, Shimaseki, Rhino, Blender, Das3D. It becomes a lot to organize and keep up with all of your assets on multiple platforms. Plus, your non-3D assets like flat sketches, graphics, prints. On top of that, handling the client comments and revisions, and attempting to find a way to do it all efficiently. This is where Folio 3D enters the picture. Before we get into the demo, I want to let you know that Folio 3D by Embody is the sponsor of today's video. Folio 3D is a tool that helps you centralize your digital assets, streamline project tracking, and easily collaborate with your clients. So, let me show you how to add your digital assets to Folio 3D, share them with your client, and more easily manage the admin part of your project as well. The first thing you'll need to do is add your 3D product to the app. And there are two ways you can do this. If you're a Clo3D or VStitcher user, you can download a plugin. I'm using Clo3D, so once you complete the installation, to add your file to the Folio 3D platform, go to the Plugins menu, Plugin, Export GLB to Embody. Next, you'll see a pop-up that confirms your successful export, and it'll ask you to check the Embody Upload tool. Once you log into your account, choose and confirm where you want your file saved onto the Folio platform, and you'll see the upload in progress. If you use something other than Clo or VStitcher, or if you're on a Mac, because currently the plugins only work on Windows-based computers, you'll need to export your file in one of the open source file formats like GLB, OBJ, FBX. And Folio 3D has a help article listing some of the more common 3D software and the best file formats and export settings for each. So I'm exporting from Style 3D, and I'll use Folio 3D's recommendation to export as an FBX. Then, to add it to the Folio space, choose Add Product, and go through the remaining guided steps to add the 3D asset to Folio 3D. So right now I've got two denim looks that I want to share with my client. And right off the bat, I want to make sure I start with keeping things organized. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a folder hierarchy. And you can make this as detailed as you need for your business. I'm going to organize mine by client, then season, then collection. Next thing I want to do is add any additional assets to the product file, anything from flat sketches, schematic renders, graphics, prints, additional scans of fabric options. You can choose to share those assets with your client, or you can keep them private, just adding them to this style as a way to keep yourself organized. I'm adding some black and white schematic renders of the dress so they can see the seam details more clearly. I'm also going to add a flat sketch. And something really helpful about Folio 3D is that Illustrator and Photoshop files are acceptable file types, so you don't have to convert them first. One less step. Now, keep in mind that if those files are something you're going to make available for your client to see, as long as they have a PDF viewer in their browser, which most do at this point, they'll be able to open and view the Illustrator file without issue. However, if your client does not have access to Photoshop, it's best to resave that as a JPEG or PNG file so they can view it. I'm also going to include an MP4 file. Currently, that is something your client will need to download to view. However, most people at this point have some type of video viewer to play MP4 files. Some other organizational tips: you can add tags to your product in case you need to search for a style later. Also, if your style was uploaded through the plugin, you may need to update the product name as well as add a reference code. The last thing I suggest you update is the status. This is going to come in handy later when you're doing follow-up as you go through your open projects and figure out what's approved, what needs to be corrected, what needs to be resubmitted. And getting into the habit of updating the status of your styles just helps you keep better track of your workload. Also, keep in mind that if this isn't your normal terminology, meaning if you have different phrasing you use for different phases of approval that you move through when working with your clients, note that all of these statuses are editable, even the color. So you can fully customize this to be whatever makes sense for your business. Last important thing, don't forget to save. Before you share the style, there's a few more steps you want to do before sending it to your client. First, make your style public. Next, update your link options. Give it a title and expiration date. Add a watermark, which I think is an amazing feature. Unfortunately, designers get their design stolen all the time. It's not something we like to think about, but it does happen. Now, listen, if someone wants your design, they're going to find a way to get it. But I always say, you don't have to make it easy for them. So add your watermark. And this is customizable, so you can upload your logo and control the opacity. Decide if you want to include the product files, and most importantly, turn on guest commenting so your client can easily provide feedback. Then click Generate Link, and Folio 3D gives you the option of sharing a link or a QR code. Now, one of the things that can be tricky, especially if your client is viewing your design on a computer, is understanding how to navigate. Zooming, panning, etc. On mobile, we're used to doing this with our fingers, but on desktop, you may need to give your client some help. A simple way to do that is to just leave a comment with instructions. To do that, click the comment bubble in the right panel and add your instructions as the first comment. There may also be specific areas of your design you want your client to pay more attention to, and for those, you may want to add a highlighted comment directly on the garment. Two last interesting features. If the color of your garment doesn't look quite as good or vibrant, or if you decide you want to try a different colorway once you upload your garment, click Material Setup, Fabric, choose your fabric, and in the right side panel, go to Material Base Color. You can play with the color intensity, add a color overlay, or if you want more pure color, turn on desaturation first and then play with the color. Lastly, you can change the lighting and the scene. For that, you'd click Scene, and here you can experiment with preset artificial lights, as well as a few preset environments. When you're ready to share this, go back to the product section, click the share icon, copy the link or QR code, and then send it to your client. On the client side, when they click your link or scan your QR code, they'll see your garment fully protected by your watermark, but not obscuring the design. The first comment informing them how to interact with your 3D asset. A place for them to add additional comments, even add a screenshot of a particular part of the design with an annotation. Your files, if you've given them access, and the highlighted comment. And once your client reviews and adds their comments, you'll see a red dot over the notification bell in Folio 3D, indicating that there are new comments for you to review. If you need to share multiple files, go to your collection folder where all of your styles are saved and select them all. Before you send them, make sure they have tags, set the status, and make sure all of the styles are public. Then click the share icon, add a grid name, expiration date, turn on the watermark, and then generate a shared link. Spaces allow you to create a complete presentation to share with your client. You can add your 3D interactive products as well as bring in images that further sell the idea and show a complete concept. To start, click Add a Space, start from scratch or choose a template, and then click Edit to start building your board. Remove template images and text boxes that you don't need, and begin adding your images by clicking the plus and adding files from your device. Resize, crop if necessary, and arrange them on your board. On the left, there are tools to add text, arrows, shapes, frames, or even freehand sketch. To add your 3D product, click the plus again, and this time choose Product. Choose your design from the drop-down menu and click Select. Be sure to periodically click Save and Continue, and when you've completed your board, click Done. Here's my completed board, and if you hover over the products, you'll see an icon that will allow you to interact with it in a 3D viewer. One last thing about spaces: to share your space, you'll need to go back into Edit and turn Shared on. Then click the share icon and repeat steps you've done previously. The last thing I'm going to talk about in Folio 3D is tracking your work, which you can do in two areas: in products and shared links. In products, since you've added a product status to all of your products, you can quickly track what should be sent out, what needs updating, what's approved. It's a really great way to get an idea of your current workload. And in shared links, you can track not only comments on individual products, but also how many times your links have been viewed, if they've even been viewed at all. This can give you an idea of who you might need to follow up with and maybe give them a nudge to take a look at your link. Okay, lots of pros here. First of all, I love that this is one place where you can share many different types of 3D products. As I mentioned before, many 3D fashion designers are back and forth in multiple 3D programs. And then on top of that, sharing those files in the native 3D program viewer. Having one shared hub cuts down on at least two extra programs, probably more. I love that you can share this with your client, and they can also interact with the 3D asset so they experience your design as you intended. There's no special software needed. I really love that you can watermark your work. That's a biggie. I love that you can add additional files with your product so you can share everything with one link and keep all your files in one place. I think spaces are awesome for those of you that need to pitch a complete concept with color, trend, inspiration boards. This is a great way to do it. And again, adding that interactive element is just an additional bonus and takes your boards to another level. Probably what I love most is that this tool is a way for freelancers and independent 3D fashion designers to organize themselves in their workflow. Quiet as it's kept, what really helps small businesses move from one level to the next is incorporating systems, ways to streamline what you're doing and make sure you're not wasting time looking for that email or trying to find that file. And yes, whether you're an independent fashion designer or a freelancer, you are a business. Now, I know you might be thinking, really, systems? But I'm telling you, they're a bigger deal than you think. And for what 3D fashion designers do, Folio 3D is a great system to help consolidate your work so you can be more efficient, more productive, and honestly, free up some of that extra time that's currently being overrun with administrative tasks. As far as cons, there was really only one thing that was a challenge for me. Challenge, not a deal breaker. Actually, two things. First, there's currently no plugin for Style 3D, and I'm hoping that changes soon. I know Clo and Browseware right now are the main contenders when it comes to 3D fashion software, but Style 3D is quickly elbowing his way in there. The second thing is that when you share multiple styles, the client can view them, but there's no way to comment. I'm hoping that's just an oversight because that can get really annoying having to send separate links for every single style. Other than that, I really like it. And if you're asking whether I recommend Folio 3D, my answer is absolutely. And if you'd like to try the tool, Folio 3D has graciously offered 25% off for new customers for the first 3 months if you use the code Mikkel25. There's also a 14-day free trial with no credit card required, so you'll be able to try out the app first, see how you like it, see how your customers like it, and then, cherry on top, you can get a discount once you decide to move forward. Thanks for watching today's video. If you're interested in trying Folio 3D, check out the link in the comments and use the discount code to get 25% off your first 3 months. And if you're new to 3D and interested in starting your 3D journey, check out my 3D Clo course as well as other videos on this channel. You can find those links also in the description or right here on the screen. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.